All right, so today is Cyber Monday, which is like basically the last day of the whole Black Friday deals week, whatever. And what happens in audio is that there are a lot of new plugins being released around Black Friday. And normally I would cover like as many as I could, like I did last year. But as you can hear, my voice was gone. Now today it's back a little bit, and there's one plugin that I really want to take a look at, and that is the Motet, or M-O-T-T, by Slate Digital. So let's take a look until my voice stops again. All right, so M-O-T-T, what does it stand for? I've been reading the website already. I can't figure it out. What is M-O-T-T? Yeah, it says it over here. What is M-O-T-T? But it still doesn't say what M-O-T-T stands for. Like, OTT stands for over the top, as far as I know. If I'm incorrect, it is in the comments already. I know that for sure. But MOTT, what's that then? Is that like more over the top? They're not saying that. I don't know what MOTT is. Mod. It's mod. Anyway, what it basically is an improved version of the original OTT, well, preset in Ableton. But there's also an OTT plugin, which I think is basically the same thing. There should be an original one-to-one reproduction of OTT in there, but there are also new features, vast spacious presence of vocals, quick set modes, controlling the speed of the transients, which is really interesting if you have a very transient responsive sound system, which I think I have, and tweak your sound as much as you want without ever breaking the preset thanks to global macros. Oh, that's actually interesting. I think how that works is that you get a few controls, which in the background control more. So it's easier to control. That's a great idea. So it's got two views, easy and advanced. And yeah, why don't we just hop in there and take a look at it. All right, so let's take a quick look. We've got the settings here. Clip off, clip on, soft knee, hard knee, RMS, peak, low amount, mid amount, low, high timings. Okay, interesting, interesting. Few easy controls. And we also got advanced and then... okay. Upwards ratio and downward. Yeah, of course, yeah. OTT is is both a compressor and an expander. So what we're going to do is we're going to play a track, which I've forgotten the name of, but I think the guys in the comment can comment what the name of the track is. So yeah, let's do that. Oh, it even has birds, this track. Yeah, birds. Well, one thing is for certain, it's over the top. It's really over the top. Okay, let's adjust the amount. Like, I've got sub frequencies in my snap now. Like radio compression. Quite honestly, this user interface is already, it's so easy to control already. Oh, we can even do the balancing here. You know what would be cool? If you could add more bands. Like create a, I don't know, 4 or 5 band OTT. I don't think that's possible. I don't know. But I think that like how this user interface works, just the easy one, you can already get pretty far into your sound that you want to create. Like, it's almost, it's almost a limiter. Maybe it is a limiter. But like, it flattens everything so much, which sometimes is like, can really create a sound, and sometimes you really don't want to have it. Because it's so aggressive, it's easy to overdo it. And the aggressiveness sometimes really comes across as better. Isn't necessarily true. Maybe, I mean, what is better? That's also a discussion, like, well, we don't know what is better. Anyway, let's take a look at the advanced section. Let's advance into advanced. Right, let's put it to here and quickest attack. Can we solo it? We can solo it, cool. Whoa. That's a lot of... Whoa. That's of course because of the attack time, I think. Yeah. Oh, so if you put your attack time too short, it will... It says logical. It will distort. So we can even go negative in the ratio. So what would that mean? That would mean like... Okay, so we have the curve like this. This is like flat. So then it would go... Would go back again. So that would mean that it's like... compressing further, then it's not an expander then. No, it's because an expander would be like this, like going up. So it would go down. So it compresses more than the input signal. So if the input signal comes above the threshold, the output signal will be below the threshold. Wow. That can create some interesting effects. Yeah. So if you put these two together and turn up the ratios enough, you can really flatten that frequency band. Like it's really making sure that everything stays at the same level. It's kind of a powerful thing to have like expander and compression in the same thing, in the same control. You're basically just creating a region in which you want to have your volume, your whatever. Wow, thing can really distort. Turn it down, maybe make it a little bit quicker. So makeup gain would be this then, right? This, yeah, okay. So about OTT, do people actually master with OTT? Let me know in the comments, because it's such a sensitive thing, OTT as well. Like this is of course more OTT or whatever. Because I'm just wondering about the use case. Like, it's so aggressive. It's so aggressive. Of course, I'm sure I can make a calmer preset with like longer timings, a lower amount, that kind of stuff. But it's like driving like a super powerful car that has like if you only use a little bit on the accelerator, on the gas pedal, on the I don't know, maybe even the current pedal. The electricity pedal, the whatever you want to call it, you only push it a little bit, that it already accelerates really hard. That's a bit how this feels. And which is a car you can drive like normal and calm, but you always feel from the car that it doesn't really want to do that. I think that's also the reason why, for instance, Tesla has that like relaxed mode for acceleration, and also a lot of cars have like sport or what would the other one be? Comfort or something. But yeah, that's about cars. I'm talking about this plugin, but it really reminds me of that. Yeah, let's take a look at the timing style and also at the Vox style, but I'll need a track with vocals in it then. Yeah, I'll search for track. I All right, so scratch what I just said. Oh my God. I know how frustrated you all are about how I'm looking at plugins, like just discovering it as I go. But scratch that story that I just said, like this timing style changes it. Scratch the whole car story, because if you put it in smooth, that's the gear lever. That's the setting difference. Like what I just said about the gear lever, that's over here. It's a timing style. Now I can turn it up. Awesome. Still OTT, of course, but... Awesome. So this is your gear lever. This is your setting, your acceleration setting. It's over there. Whole story about cars. Okay, so I've got a track with vocals, but now my question is actually like, is Vox meant push the vocals? Or is Vox meant to compress vocals? Because if it's like individual vocals, because if it's meant for individual vocals, I do not have a clean vocal track that I can use, that I have the rights to use. I hope that I've understand this correctly, and if not, then then... Close me somehow, now I'm I think this is for vocals, just vocals. Close me somehow, now I'm waist deep, thinking about you all the time like crazy, knowing you're here by my side, and I was doing fine. Oh, but this can work really well on vocals, because here's a thing with vocal compression. This is not a good example, I know, but that's also what demos are for, so you can try it out yourself on your own, like dry vocals. But with most of all electronic music productions, sometimes it's a bit hard to get the vocal on top of the music. I normally use like a combination of multiple compressors, actually. Sometimes I'm like really using the distressor in combination with sometimes a Pro C or sometimes even a Pro L, like a limiter, hard limiter, just to get the vocals up in the mix loud enough, powerful enough, and that kind of stuff to really get it in the mix. What I'm already hearing here is that it's really, really flattening up that vocal really well. Actually never thought about using the original OTT on vocals. Never thought about it. It would actually work really well. But this would also work really well. So yeah, what I think the best to do with this thing is just try it out yourself and you would understand what I mean. And you can try it out yourself, as far as I know, because it has a free trial for a month. For one full month, you can try it out yourself. So yeah, that's it for my look at MotiT, which promises to be like OTT on steroids, OTT advanced, whatever you want to call it. I think it does what it promises. It's that simple to say. But of course, never trust just me, in my opinion. Try it out yourself. That's what trials are for. And draw your own conclusions. And then maybe come back to the video and drop below what you think. For the disclosure, I was running the MotiT from my All Access Pass that I purchased for the tape plugin shootout video. So yeah, maybe I'll take a look at more Slate plugins now that I have that pass for a month. Or maybe keep the pass for longer. I don't know yet. I'm not using Slate plugins in my day-to-day workflow. So if there's no reason to have an All Access Pass, I'll just cancel it again. I'm not in contact with Slate. They're not seeing this video before the rest of the world. And I'm not. They haven't even asked me to take a look at it or whatever. This is all completely my own initiative and also my complete transparent opinion. And if you appreciate my independence, make sure to support me, because that keeps me away from making deals with manufacturers, making shady deals and that kind of stuff. So if you want to support me, make sure to do that by using the links down below. You can buy merchandise, which I'm not wearing today. No, I'm not wearing merchandise today. You can buy merchandise. You can use my affiliate link. There are two links, both from Thomann and Sweetwater. Buy something using the affiliate link and a little bit of your purchase gets kicked to me. You're not paying anything extra for your purchase, so it's a great way to help me out. Another way to support me is by pledging with the Patreon campaign, and Patreon is basically just the fan club, the paid fan club. It's over here, and you get early access to videos, answers to your questions, and some other good stuff. So check it out, it's all over here. Last way to support me and the whole YouTube platform is by watching more videos, because that's what they want you to do. So I'll link one of my own videos over here, but there's a recommended section around here where you can see a lot of videos from different creators, all tailored to your own taste. That's a great thing from the algorithm. For now, I want to thank you all for watching. Keep pushing and bye-bye.